how. We're gonna make it happen. Let's take a ride and spend the day in the countryside.
Good times are here to stay. We'll get away and have the perfect picnic. We'll sing a song and absolutely nothing will go wrong.
The Lego version of the classic Disney castle. Now, this version of the Disney castle was made before Disney decided to give it a brand new paint job, which happened just recently. I think it was about a few weeks ago. But still, this set, it was super awesome. It took me a long time, more than a week, to complete.
How many pieces?
So this set had over 4,000 pieces. According to the box, it had 4,080 pieces. And I love the way that Lego paid attention to the design of the Disney castle, the pre-paint job Disney castle. Just take a look at this. So first, we have Mickey, Minnie, Tinkerbell, Donald, and Daisy, all outside the front door waiting for guests to arrive so that they can meet and greet them. And right up here is the little clock, which is still pretty cool. I think this one kind of looks like what Disney Castle would look like during the holidays. This is the way that they're arranged. And here's the side of the Disney Castle. Alright, so one of the cool things about this Disney castle set is that it features a lot of classic Disney movies. Like this little archery set up here. And I don't really have the bow and arrow. Oh well. It said that it's used to represent the Disney movie Brave. But you can also use it to represent the older Disney movie Robin Hood. And let me know in the comments, who do you think is a better archer? Robin or Merida? So it does feature at least 10 different Disney movies. The first one we're focusing on is the one that Disney made the first, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. So we have the Magic Mirror and the Poisoned Apple. So the room below it has a little treasure chest. You can see the cannons in the background. Those represent the fireworks that Disney loves to display each and every night. At least prior to the pandemic causing Disney to close down for a few months. But the little treasure chest actually has a strand of hair and a comb used to represent the Disney hit film Tangled, based on the story of Rapunzel. And a little corner there and down here is the spinning wheel which Princess Aurora pricked her finger on, causing her to go to sleep in Sleeping Beauty. Next, we have the suite bed right here. This one is the Walt Disney. There is a Walt Disney suite inside of the real Disney castle. And you could use this bed as part of the set to represent that if you wanted to. Here's the kitchen from Prince Eric's castle from Disney's Little Mermaid. You can also have the pumpkin just like that too in order to celebrate Halloween. It is also the enchanted pumpkin from Cinderella. And speaking of enchanted, there's a Beauty and the Beast room. On the left is Lumiere and on the right is the enchanted rose. And that little space in the middle is a place where you can put your Belle and the Beast minifigures to reenact your favorite scene from that film. Now personally, I liked both the animated and the live action versions of Beauty and the Beast. And The Little Mermaid was a fun film, too. Here's a little fun thing. That's the Genie's Lamp and Carpet from Disney's Aladdin. Now, as I said in my Walt Life episode, I pretty much like the animated version of Aladdin a little bit better than I did the live-action version. But still, though, that is a fun movie to watch, especially for the songs. And right down here is kind of where the base of the castle is. This is where all the Disney fans will be able to walk through and leave today and enter a world of yesterday, tomorrow, and fantasy. And right here is where we can have a grandfather clock. We have a chandelier. We have some shields that you can use to represent the movie Brave. Kind of top here is kind of empty, but you can use that for whatever you want to, whatever your heart desires. So one of the neat things about this set is that if you remove this tower like so, you have a secret little compartment where you can hold the glass things like Cinderella's glass slipper and all sorts of cool items, and even a little book too. Another cool thing is that these knights here are actually minifigures, so you can pretend that they can come alive during the Halloween season and kind of haunt your characters like Scooby and Shaggy. And right next to the spinning wheel, we have a room that represents Sorcerer Mickey from the hit film Fantasia. You can see his hat. There are the buckets, and there are the brooms that Mickey turns alive in that classic scene. This is still pretty cool. And also a spellbook there, too, inside of the treasure chest. And just outside the castle on the right-hand side, you'll see a Princess Tiana and Prince Naveen from The Princess and the Frog, both in their frog forms. That's also a good movie, too, filled with lots of cool jazz music. This room up on top of the Snow White room can kind of be like a little break room for your character. So when they need to take a break from meeting and greeting all the fans that they see down below. Oh. Pretty cool. So you can definitely have a lot of fun with this set. You can recreate some of your favorite scenes from your favorite Disney films, both animated and live action. And you can even have some Lego figures from some non-Disney sets come in here and pretend that they're having a magical vacation at Walt Disney World. Like you could have Emmett and Wild Style go out for a vacation. We have like the Ghostbusters if you wanted, the Scooby-Doo. I know those guys have all Lego minifigures, especially in Lego Dimensions. They can have a lot of fun here. I know Scooby and Shaggy would definitely love it here because of the food. Anyway, folks, that's going to conclude today's episode of DB Lego. Hope you all enjoyed. If you did, please make sure to leave a like, and don't forget to subscribe if you're new. And have a magical day, everyone. Thanks for watching.